why not? They deserve it. Also, congratulations to Bafana Bafana as well. Twice now winning against Sao Tome. And four goals scored today, conceding two. Will they be happy with that? We have absolutely no idea. But we've got a member of a very unique club called the Club 100. That's because... and she knows. She knows why she's laughing. Because she belongs in that special, special, special group. And the only African to have ever scored 100 goals in international football. Only. Yeah, she became the first. Anit.
Right.
And how does it feel to be in the club? Worldwide now.
Mommy, I would feel good, you know, number one. But I once even said, oh, Ronaldo, when you score the first 100 that he scored, everyone was celebrating. But I was like, Marana, South African elite, they had their own, they couldn't celebrate their own that much. But now they're talking about Ronaldo, which is the first late.
Why do you think they were not celebrating you as much?
I'm sure I didn't feel the vibe that much, but I know which are people that they always supporting me. Yeah. Sometimes you want to be celebrated by a federation, but you know, I think you deserve it because they're the first people to give you that recognition because you've been presenting. But sometimes it's nice when other people they could celebrate you, but it needs to come to from them.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. All right. If there are any sound issues, we're going to try and be on top of them. Thank you for letting us know, though, but so we will deal with that as we go through. Pasha Labisa is the legend that's sitting right here with me. Later on, we are going to be having two coaches from Mamelodi Sundowns, Mangoba Muti, as well as Rolando Mkwene, going to be joining us here. So keep those questions firing through. Whatever you want to have answered on the show today, today is that opportunity for you to do that. So they are in studio. We're going to be chatting to them in just a second. So, Pasha, from your side, you just come straight back from Port Elizabeth, where obviously the Kasafa tournament was happening. Not that you're playing, not that you're coaching. So what are you doing?
In Brahapa was doing TSG. Uh-huh. Kasafa normally select players, you know, for Kasafa, play of the match, play of the tournament, top goal scorer. So we are the one really watching the talent throughout all the games. And also I'm an ambassador of the tournament where I'll go and try to spread the word, you know, about the tournament, to say people they need to support them, go to the website and try to really support the Kasafa tournament.
So the appointment comes through from Kasafa, not from Safa?
Yes, not from Safa, from Kasafa.
How does that work?
I met a lady that calls me that is handling Kasafa, then he was like, in France, and he was like, he wanted me to become an ambassador in Kasafa, he wants to work with me. Then I was really privileged to get to that invitation, and I really took it with both hands, and I'm enjoying it.
Right, so you obviously had a difficult task of choosing, finding out who's going to be the player of the tournament and all of those major things. What is that learning like? What did you learn from that?
The talent, because put the talent. Mm-hmm. It's not a concern. We play football, and for me, it's nice. I could say it's nice to know which I'm part of that team that is really could scout the talent and see if there's an opportunity. Because the La Liga is also having a sponsorship with them. That's what you want to see, those